can be fun to start making actuarial videos about advanced actuarial topics. I see people posting videos on YouTube about the preliminary exams, but I haven't come across anybody making free study resources for advanced actuarial exams. So I thought I'd take a break from talking about my life as an actuary and actually try to teach you some things, if you want to learn it. The fun thing about advanced actuarial exams is that the math actually isn't very hard. My parents always tell people, oh, I couldn't even begin to understand the math that Michelle does every day. Yeah, they could. The preliminary exams are full of advanced mathematical topics. Statistics, infinite series, Monte Carlo simulation. Advanced exams, at least the ones that I wrote, mostly stick to addition, multiplication, and in the case of what I'm going to show you today, the tiniest little bit of geometry. Today I want to show you how actuaries read parallelograms. Eventually this goes on to do things like on-leveling premium, aggregating exposures, but today we're just going to go over the basics of when I see an actuarial parallelogram, what am I looking at? First, I want you guys to remember the main reason why we need actuaries and insurance companies. The timing problem. First, insurance companies collect your money, then they pay out your claim if you happen to have one. Since insurance companies want to charge a fair price for a person's expected losses, and insurance companies want to make sure that they hold enough money to pay out those losses when they do come in, we need some fancy math and some fancy parallelograms. Insert clip from PowerPoint, let's see if the PowerPoint clip works!
Let's say that you sell a one-year insurance policy on January 1st, 2017. That means that the insurance policy is going to be in force effectives on the book until December 31st, 2017. And then on January 1st, 2018, the policy would either get renewed or expire. For what I'm doing today, we're not thinking about renewals, we're just thinking about the 1 year time period. Right now, the image that you should be seeing, if my animations are working probably, looks a lot like a flat line. To make it two-dimensional, what we do is we double up the timeline. The bottom line represents the moment that the policy sells. Top line represents the moment when the policy expires. And we draw a diagonal line from start to finish to represent the policy. Now if I add a few more policies, are you starting to see some parallelograms? Great. Because of the ever-famous insurance timing problem, actuaries, and insurance companies in general, have many ways of looking at years. I know, I said it at the beginning, the math, not super hard, the concepts, tough to get your head around. Calendar year is probably your most basic way of looking at years. I'm going to keep talking in terms of years, but this can also be done for a month, a quarter, a decade, it doesn't have to be a year. On our parallelogram timeline, if everything is drawn to scale, each calendar year is represented by a square. If we want to know the number of policies that were written or sold in that year, just look at the lower timeline of the square, in this case, 4. If you want to know the number of policies that expired in that year, you look at the upper timeline of the square, in this case, 2. Things get interesting when you look at policy D, or any line that crosses outside of its calendar year square for that matter. It starts in one calendar year and ends in another calendar year. When you throw insurance claims in the mix, this gets very interesting. Let's say their house burns down in 2018. It might take 3 years before the insurer pays the claim. So you collect the premium in 2017, the claim happens in 2018, and the claim is paid in 2021. If we only came up with insurance prices by looking at calendar year, you would look at the year that the policy was sold and say, we collected $500 from this person, they cost us nothing, maybe the policy is overpriced. Jump forward to the year when you actually make the claim payment and there's no policy to associate it with anymore. I'm not going to get into the specifics of aggregation and on-leveling in this video, because it would make the video even longer than it already is, but if you're interested, there's always that like button in the comments section. Let's say that instead of looking at calendar year, we want to look at a policy year. Instead of a square this time, we want to follow the start date of the first possible policy sold in the year through to the expiration of the last possible policy sold. I say possible policy because the insurer doesn't have to have sold a policy on January 1st for you to start your policy year on January 1st. We just want a 12-year period when we're talking years. If we're talking months, you just want a 1-month period. Policy years show up as a parallelogram in our timeline. The interesting thing about a policy year is that it actually spans 2 calendar years. This particular policy year starts on January 1st, 2017, but ends all the way on December 31st, 2018. One of the advantages of the first type of year that I showed, the calendar year, is that at the end of the year, you know your results. With a policy year, it takes 2 years before you've got all your results in. Let's add back some more policies. If we want to know the number of policies that were written or sold in that policy year, just look at the lower timeline of the parallelogram, in this case, 4. If we want to know the number of policies that expired in that policy year, you look at the upper timeline. And assuming that no one canceled their policy before it expired, it's going to be the same number as the one sold in that year. The last quick thing that I'm going to show you guys today is how to calculate the number of in-force policies. In-force just means a snapshot view of the number of policies that are effective on a given date. Using our timeline, if we want to know how many policies are in force on November 1st, we just draw a straight line through November 1st and count the number of policies that it intersects with. So for the policies that are already expired, we're not responsible for any new accidents they have on November 1st. And for the policies that haven't started yet, we're not responsible either. It's just the ones that touch the vertical line.
Whew, I think that is enough actuarial content for one day. Be sure to click that subscribe button if you want to learn more about real actuarial concepts, or just join me in my actuarial YouTuber journey. Thank you for calling. Bye!